Hello, good morning and welcome. Today we will start with one of the most exciting areas in the field of communication. Thinking, what is it? Yes, communication research. Oh my God, I can see a lot of frown on your face. Why are you so scared about the word research? Let me tell you, it is the most enjoyable aspect of the entire study of communication. And I assure you that at the end of the class, you will really, really appreciate what is research is all about. So let us start and see how the entire concept of research began. And let me tell you, the concept of research never occurred till the man started thinking about systematic thinking. Surprised? Of course it's true. So the very technique of systematic thinking was developed around 300 BC by the Greek philosopher Aristotle. And remember, in the communication or introduction to communication class, I had made a mention that Aristotle was the first person to give us a model of human communication when he asked the questions, who says what to whom with what effect. Even there, at that time, he established a systematic method of understanding the process of communication. So today, again, we will begin with Aristotle. He gave a concept of deductive logic. According to him, in a systematic thinking or in a process which systematically investigate certain concepts, there is a major premise followed by a major premise. Based on the major and minor premise, we draw conclusions. What is this called as? This is called as Aristotle's syllogism. So they were all syllogists, systematic thinkers, philosophers. Look at his proposition. He says, all men are mortal. Socrates is a man, hence Socrates is mortal. So naturally, we all know that we all die one day. So all men are mortal, a major premise. Socrates is a man, a minor premise. And Socrates is obviously mortal, that is our conclusion, because we know one day Socrates is going to die. So this deductive logic was very, very useful technique of thinking for a number of years to come to explain certain problems systematically. However, this deductive logic can be questioned and said, in case if the major premise itself is wrong or questionable, naturally the conclusions will be questionable. Let me put it this way. All men are good. Socrates is a good man. Socrates is a good man. All men are good. Socrates is a man. Socrates is a good man. Absolutely nothing wrong with this major premise, minor premise, and conclusion. But the question here is, how are we sure that all men are good? When we know, per se, there are men who are good, there are men who are bad. So in such a situation where the major premise itself is questionable, the deductive logic did not work. But however, in those days, in a very simple way of life, deductive logic worked, and it worked for a very, very long time. But at a later stage, another great thinker, philosopher, brought in a totally a new concept called as inductive logic. What does it mean? Francis Bacon in 1620 proposed the concept of inductive logic and said, there will be a statement of major premise, there will be a minor premise, however, conclusions are drawn on individual observations. So here, the conclusions are not merely drawn on the major premise, conclusions are not merely drawn on the basis of a minor premise, the conclusions are drawn based on the individual observations we make. And he goes on to write a very beautiful story in his book called Novum Organum. And I will tell you this story before I end this class. It's a very interesting story. During those days of Lord, the king was celebrating his birthday. And happy, he started giving a free gift to his people, the ministers, the soldiers, the captains, anybody, men of worth. So what did he give them? Each one of them was given a horse. So individuals took the horse, bowed to the king and went away. There comes a very young soldier who receives the horse and asks a simple question, my lord, how many teeth are there in the mouth of this horse? And immediately all the great philosophers in the kingdom, they run and run, search for the books, search for the scriptures everywhere, and they find no answer to this question. Angry on the young lad, they come and beat him up and say, how dare you ask this question to our Lord? And they ask him, do you know the answer for this? He said, yes, I know the answer. Just open the mouth of the horse and count. You would know how many teeth are there in the horse. And for this, he is beaten black and blue and kicked out of the kingdom. You see the power of observation here. So this is exactly what Francis Bacon was trying to tell us. Major premise is important. And based on the major premise, we write a minor premise. And based on the minor premise, we make appropriate observations. Then draw conclusions about what we have observed over a period of time. And this inductive logic becomes the base of modern research. In the next class, we will discuss the beginning of modern research and see what John Dewey in 1932 gave us, a combination of deductive logic and inductive logic. Goodbye till then.